What's up, guys? So today we got a Bob question, and today's Bob question is about our friend who has a coach and they don't like the way that their coach coaches them around competition time. Now, Bob says that when their coach is not getting ready for a competition or they're not at the competition, they're fantastic, right? The training's fun, they're a great human being and they like being around them, but when it's competition time, either in the gym when it's getting close or in the competition itself, their coach has this very aggressive barking style, yelling at them, telling them to do things, and they say they don't respond to it very well. They say it kind of flusters them, it sort of throws them off a little bit. That's not just their style. And a lot of times when they're in competitions and they take this advice, they get caught in weird submissions because they're like, you know, they feel something and they feel like it's a bad idea, but their coach is barking at them, so they do it anyway and they get caught in stuff. And so it's very frustrating. And the kicker to this is that when their coach is not present, when their head coach is not there and they've got one of the assistants who does not coach that way, they do really well. They're getting up on the podium and they're winning consistently. So you have the situation where, you know, their coach, the person they like, when it comes to competitions, it's coaching. It's, they don't like that style, but they can see that, you know, based upon the two, when that coaching style is not present, they seem to do better, both, you know, in results and the way that they feel mentally. And so their question is how do you deal with this? How do you talk to your coach and ask them not to do something when you're just a blue belt? Because this person's a blue belt. And they're like, I'm just a blue belt. Like, I don't feel like I should be suggesting or telling anybody to do anything, but I just know I don't like it. So Bob, thank you so much for the question. And this is a really good thing. So the reason I wanted to pick this question in particular, because here's the thing. One of the things that's made me so much better as a coach is by taking feedback from my students, right? Because again, when you start doing something, I don't know how it works for people. You know, they have to tell me, right? But someone will come up to me and say, hey, Chewy, you know that movie show? Uh-huh. That worked great. Right? Or, hey, you know that thing you said to me the other day? Uh-huh. That made a lot of sense. Or, Chewy, you know that thing you did? Yeah. I didn't like that. Oh, why not? Because of this. Or that thing you showed, that didn't work for me. Why not? Show me why. Boom. And I can get this feedback, right? And it's so helpful. Because for me, like, I want to be the best possible coach that I can be. And the only way I can do that is if I get feedback. It's the same way when you train, right? When you train and you roll, right? You're basically in this system, this big feedback loop where you take a move you've been drilling or working on, whatever it might be, and then you take it and you roll with it and you get feedback. What works, what doesn't work, right? So then when you get that feedback, you can say, okay, did it work? Perfect, keep it going. Didn't work? Why not? Let's find out, right? And so that kind of just like for the coaching, right? It tells me like, hey, right? Like, what do I need to do? And so I think your coach is probably very similar. They probably want to be the best possible coach to you and to all the training partners that they can be in your gym, right? So giving them feedback probably will not be looked at as such a negative thing. You know, it could be, I guess, if they're insecure, but if they're not, they're going to look at this being like, oh, one of my students has a problem. Well, let me help them fix that. Now, here's the next thing. I just thought about this because the other day, one of my students and I, there was just something kind of weird going on. It wasn't anything crazy, but it was something that was bothering them. So they sent me a text message. They're like, hey, Chewy, do you have a little bit of time before class to talk? And I was like, yeah, absolutely, sure. And so they came into the gym and we got together maybe about, you know, 15 to 20 minutes before the classes started. And we just sat down with each other. We talked and it was kind of a difficult conversation for them, right? I'll say it like that. It wasn't a big deal, but it was a difficult conversation to bring up because it was kind of personal. And after we talked though, we talked and it was fine. Like, it was done, right? So it was initially kind of difficult, but a lot of times we just build stuff up in our own head, right? And so what I would say to you, Bob, is that when you want to talk to your coach, I think that you bringing it up to him is not going to be that big of a deal. They probably want to be the best coach they can to you. And by going up to him and saying, hey, listen, I love you as a human being. You're so cool. But I just don't like this particular way of coaching. I don't respond to it well, right? And I can tell you from my experience, Bob, I don't respond to that kind of coaching. One of my old coaches used to coach me like that, and I had to ask them to stop because it bothered me. I was like, because, you know, there's this thing that happens where, like, if I'm coaching someone, I can see some things that they can't, but I can't feel what they're feeling. And a lot of times what would happen for me is, like, I would be caught in something, and my coach would be barking at me, and I'm like, they've got my arm trapped. Move your right arm. I can't because it's trapped. You know, like, there's this frustrating thing going on. So a lot of times, if you ever watch me, the way that I coach, like, say, Chad, for instance, or any of my students, and it's almost like a catcher and, like, a pitcher, you know, like, where they're like, you know, the pitcher sits in the mound, and he's like, doing this thing, they're shaking their heads and they're like signaling each other. You know, I might yell something to someone, hey, throw your right leg over. And, you know, they'll be like trapped, like shake their head. Just kind of let me know that they can't do it, that kind of thing. We're communicating a little bit in that situation where I see something, but again, I can't feel what you're doing. So I don't want to tell you to do it if you can't do it. So anyway, I'm kind of veering off topic here. Have the difficult conversation with your coach. Just let them know. Just think of it not as that you're trying to correct someone. Don't think of it as you're trying to tell them what to do. Think of it as you're giving them feedback, as you would if a technique wasn't working. This is a technique that they're using for their teaching. Let them know if it's working or not working for you so that they can adjust and improve. So that's my thought on it, okay? So Bob, thank you so much for the question and good luck.